Good morning. Welcome to Revelation Wellness Northwoods Summer Sweat Series. We're here on Saturday morning, or if you're watching this recording, whatever day of the week it happens to be. So how this kind of works, we do a little message, whatever the Lord has kind of put on my heart for this week, and then we'll just kind of let that message ruminate or so to speak during the movement that we do. And then so we'll do a little bit of just one song of drumsticks this week. So if you don't have whatever sticks with you, go grab those. You can use wooden spoons, literally whatever you can find, knitting needles, pencils, chopsticks. I've heard it all. So you want to go grab those. But if you don't have them, don't worry about it. You can just pretend. We just have the one song. And then we'll get into, we have a little bit different format this week. We're going to be using some fun props. I'll show you in a minute. And then we'll close out with a couple more movements together and do a nice cool down and time to receive. So I like to give this disclaimer. What I do are suggestions. And if you are not moving the way that I'm moving, that's just fine. Don't feel like it needs to look a certain way. God has prepared this time and this space for you in your day to move how he has created you to move. And it shouldn't look like your neighbor. Right? Everyone's created individually, and thank goodness, right? Life would be so boring if we were all cookie cutters. So I'm going to try to give modifications all along the spectrum. Just hop in wherever you feel works for you today. That sounds like all I needed to say. So today's message is called Cracked Cisterns. So reading from Jeremiah 2:13. I'm going to grab this book here. This is before Jeremiah. There's a very real well within each of us. It is our soul, the place we draw from. Jeremiah calls it a cistern. For my people have committed a twofold sin. They have abandoned me, the fountain of fresh, flowing, living water. And they've dug for themselves cracked cisterns that can hold no water at all, that are no better than sieves or sieves. Should have looked at the pronunciation. So we all have a past, some good, some bad, some both. It's not really a matter of whether the past was cruel or kind to you. The greater danger lies in trying to live in what is gone. We were created to live not in the shadow of glory or shame, but in the light of now as we look to a future of increasing brightness. The attacks on your life have more to do with who you might be in the future than who you have been in the past. All right, we'll talk more about that as we get going, but just let that simmer around, come to a nice boil maybe. Okay, so I'm going to start our playlist. Grab your sticks if you have them. I don't know. Okay, you're gonna grab your sticks here. We're gonna pull back, it's down. Other side. If you wanna stay on one side, you can. Or you can keep alternating like this. So I just added a little leg lift. And again, if you're not hitting the ground, that's just fine. And if your leg raise is just a tap to the side, that's good too. Okay, so you're gonna hit forward, up, then you're gonna take it to a side lunge there, or you're more so pivoting into a little lunge. But again, if your movement is here, that's just fine. Hit center. Okay, so we're back. That pull. If you want to add a leg lift, you can. That's after our chorus. There you go. Lift the corners of your mouth. Soften your tailbone down to the floor. Hit doubles if you want. Give me a drum roll, wherever it is. Up. Good, drum roll. Hit up. Back to our chorus. There you go. Hit doubles if you want. Drum roll. We're gonna get up four times. You can add a little hop if you want, or it looks like that. Drum roll. Now jump, or just get up however you want. There you go. Back to our chorus. Let's go to those alternating leg lifts. Hit center. All right. You can set those sticks to the side. We won't use them anymore today. Add some water if you need it. Okay. So we are going to be doing a tabata or a HIIT round using dice. And I have a different move. Just pay attention to this part. Different move for every number. So whatever move we get, doing it for 30 seconds with a 15 second rest. We're going to do 7 rounds, take a break, 7 more rounds. So this is the cardio part of our working session today. So I have the timer. Don't worry, don't have to keep track. Okay. So I'm rolling our dice here. We have a 4. So a 4 is a lunge. Starting now, so you can either do a reverse lunge, like so, or if you want to take it up, you can add a hop. Or you can be somewhere in the middle. Good. 10 more seconds here. Wherever you are today. 3, 2, 1. Rest. I'll roll again for us. Okay. 2 is a squat. Get 3 more seconds to rest. Okay. So 30 seconds to work here. So you're squatting, hitting your bum back. I think you're going to sit down here. If you look down, you should still be able to see those toes. If you want, you can add a hop. Or a hop where you don't quite leave the ground. Whatever your level is today. Two, one, rest. We got two again. We're back to the squat. 3 more seconds of rest. Dance moves are extra. Okay, we're working. Whatever level is today, make sure you can do it with proper form. You're not feeling any pain aside from the regular discomfort that comes with work. Good. 3, 2, 1. Great. I'm just getting steamy already. I'm shaking it again. We're not doing more than 2 times in a row. Okay. 4 again. Back to those lunges. Let's really like 2s and 4s. And we're working. You just wanna leave.
I ain't never too far. Just had a little faith in
me. Remember, you can just do your reverse lunge here. When all the
fears
you
have.
Here. You're really driving through that front heel.
Oh, I'll be standing by your side.
And again, not allowing that heel to pass. And rest. Six. Okay, this one's a swimmer. You're going to come down to your belly. And you pin your legs and your arms. And you pin up in the air. Add in whatever stroke you want. Draft yourself, but your neck, the alignment is fine. You're not craning. You're enjoying the patterns on your yoga mat, or carpet, or grass, wherever you are. Good. Three. One. Rest.
When you don't know who you are,
how does it feel?
I will find you so easily.
Round of seven sets, or one set of seven rounds, however you want to look at it. Looking through your time, one more of those.
Seeing all the rainbows,
40 more seconds. Idea.
And I know that it sounds crazy. I just want to see you. Oh, I gotta ask you. You got plans tonight? I'm a couple hundred miles.
There are two that we still haven't even gotten to. A number three and a number five. If I can shake some.
Cause I can't get you off my mind. Can't get you off my mind. Can't get you off my mind.
10 more seconds of rest.
I can't seem to get you off my mind.
Okay. What? I'll roll for it. We got a three! Sorry, this is a burpee. So, the wall is going to be your friend if you need a modification. Sorry, I have to show you my backside, my best side. You're going to jump, come to a plank as if you're down.
That you shouldn't fall asleep. It'd only be a couple hours.
If that makes sense. Otherwise, you can step it out.
I'm a couple hundred miles.
Or jump it back. Oh my gosh, only three more seconds. Wherever you are. Head rest. Back to the jacks. You roll the one. Sorry, I wish I had another camera you could see. Alright. Let's get it. If you want to pick it up but you can't do it for the whole time, maybe do five jacks and then five stepping jacks. Or one star jump, three stepping jacks. Three, I was thinking two, I could fly to one, your hotel rest. Tonight. Cause I can get you off my mind. Nope, you got it too. You got plans tonight, baby. I was hoping three, I could get two, us in your paradise. What? The only thing I'm thinking about like I'm in a spotlight here. And I can get you off my mind. Can't get you off my mind. Keep it going. 10 more seconds. You can do it. Let him be your strength. And recall that you don't have to do it, and you shouldn't be doing it on your own strength. We can do all things through Christ, right? Five. Okay, so this one is a rotating push-up. You can do it against the wall. You can do it from your knees. But you have one hand out in front, the other to the side. You're gonna push up. And then you switch whichever hand is in front. If this is too much, you can do regular push-up or from your knees.
Do you remember the 21st night of September? Love was changing the minds of the tenders while chasing the clouds.
Waking up all the muscles.
Our hearts are ringing.
Two.
In the key that our souls are singing. As we dance in the
light,
remember how the stars told the night away.
And if it's just a little guy, that's it. Wake up those thigh muscles. You're already up. 15 seconds. So fun fact, a couple years ago, I went and saw Earth, Wind & Fire. And I know that's not who's singing right now, but their song, as I'm sure you already know. And it was so fun. You were by far the youngest people there. Because that mystic, you know? Good, 8 seconds. Three, two, one, rest. Okay, we have two more rounds. Four, back to our lunge. Oh yeah, it's good, it's working. So are we. Ten more seconds. Three, two, one. Yes. This may or may not be your last one. Get ready to take. Six. That's a swimmer. You have to do it. No. Down to our card game, where we are doing a little more core focus. So, I should have looked up the name. Spades? Oh no, ruin that. Clubs? Spades? Oh no. I know hearts and diamonds. Okay. So, I have a timer for 8 minutes. Maybe. Oh no. Okay, I think I know which one. Spade is the one that's like a garden tool. Okay. So I have the cards, and we're gonna do whatever suit that move, and then whatever number is on the card, we'll do that number of them. And then if it's a face card, do 8. That is just 10. Okay. Starting right now. Got the cards. So I have the 10 of diamonds. So diamonds is a plank hip dip. Recall you can use your wall and do a plank hip dip there. Or you're here, or you're here. So we got 10. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. Just rotating at your hips. 7, 8, 9, 10. Woohoo! Okay. Ace of clubs. So this is 10 bird dogs. A bird dog. You're gonna be in an all fours position. And you're lifting the opposite arm and leg. And you're really going from the thumbs up and the heel up. So, 8, 7, 6. You can also do it from your feet. That's a little more challenging. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest. Okay. Oh yeah. 4 of diamonds. Back to those plank hip dips. Woo! 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna be slipping over here. All right, King of Spades. This is an oblique twist. So, you're gonna be sitting, and if you're sitting on the floor, you just take a little recline in your chair. If you wanna take it up, you can put those feet off the ground. Twisting as if you're hugging a tree. So 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Really should have got the gray tank top today. Yeah. Heart. That is a flutter kick. Okay, so this one, you're on your back. These are either bent, straight, or anywhere. This is gonna be the most challenging, barely off the floor. So I'm gonna show you these bent. We're just doing 10, 9, 8. And the key with this one is you're squeezing your low back to the floor. There should be, it's called like a dead bug or something. So you're squishing a dead bug. There we go. So if you aren't squeezing your low back, okay, rest. That was definitely fun. Then you know you need to back off a little bit. Okay. 9 of clubs. Back to that bird dog. To move and walk out of this tomb, buried underneath. So thumbs up, heel up. Safe and sound, stuck in the ground, too lost to be found. You're just to see. Head is in line with your spine. And it's time to leave. Come on and rise up. Take a breath, you're alive now. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us? Out from the grave like Lazarus. So please. Tell you how much time is left, but I promise the timer is going. I put it on my watch, on my phone. apart. Left feet are flutter kick again. 3.5 minutes. Eight flutter kicks, please. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
He's calling us to walk out of the dark.
4.
He's giving us new 3. Resurrected hearts. Oh, come on and rise up. Take a breath, you're alive.
3 of diamonds.
Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us?
Get the dip. Do it, y'all. Y'all. Okay. 1. 2,
I know you moved on to someone new.
3.
Hope life is beautiful.
5.
You were the light for me to 6. Find my truth. I just want to say thank you.
8.
Leaving to find my soul.
You were made for hard things.
I had to go.
This might seem like
and I know
the hardest thing to do
pretty
to this.
When a heart's
and that's okay.
Grow.
Just remember that you can take some modifications.
Watching
that you can always
turn
come back to this. And show how you're improving from time to time. Okay, so it's 9 of diamonds. 9 points. And you're not alone. Even if it's imperfect, you have this awesome community of folks. And you have Father who is never going to forsake you. Whether it's through a workout or through a really tough season in life. And yes. Okay, Joker! I didn't plan for Joker. Dance party! 10 seconds, dance party. Okay. 20 seconds! Queen of Diamonds. Let's have this be our last move. 10. Blink.
Nothing to show for it now.
You can do this from a chair if you want, like an intermediate between the floor and the wall. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh yeah. Okay. So proud of you. Wait, top dad, I'm sweating.
Okay.
Next song, you have until then, which is another minute of rest on the dot. We'll have one more song of movement, and then we'll start into our cool down.
think about you like a pastime. I could cry you a river, get you baptized. Or I wasn't ready to act right. Used to always.
Right, it's important for us to own whatever past we have. That makes us that we are, that God created us to be. And by the way, He knew everything that you would experience in this life. So your past does not surprise Him. It doesn't scare Him. And I hope that it doesn't scare you. If anything, it's the enemy's way of trying to influence who you are after it happens. So from here on out, that's what the enemy is afraid of. Because he knows that you can use those hardships and you can use those tough experiences to share God's love. Okay, so I want you to take a wide stance here. Deep breath in. This one's for fun. So you're gonna take a little scoop, deep breath in. I promise the song gets a little louder. Starts off soft. So I want you to take four arrow pulls with your elbow. Other side. Good. So you're just going to do a little pull down and step behind. Let's do the footwork and then add in the arms when it makes sense. I am brave, I am bruised, I am who I'm meant to be. This is I'm just going to step wide. Starting out small. And I'm marching on to the beat I drum. I'm not scared to be seen. I make no apologies. Wide stance. This is like a rope pull. If you need to go and turn off the volume, I encourage you. Just let this one encourage you. Okay, here we go. Here's our combo. The opposite, shoulders down, clap. Cross, shoulders down, clap. Or whatever combo you think makes sense. If you're touching the floor, that's cool. If not, that's also cool. We are warriors. Back to those pulls, a little more energy this time. Good. Other side. And the cross behind with a pull down. You can add a little hop if you want to take it bigger. Take up whatever space you want. But just know, you're never a burden. Your space is never a burden. Okay, so this is like a chop. I don't really know. It's just fun. Rope pull. Again, if your rope pulls here, that's just fine. Imagine we're playing tug of war. Single, single, double. Get a little dancey if you want. Pointing to the one who makes you you. Now just stand. Your hands on your heart if you want. Good. This is prayer. This is bruise. This is who I'm meant to be. This is me. Okay. Back to the chop. Big finish. Love it. All right, now we'll start the cool down. Okay. A little heartbeat here. Ooh, fancy. You try. Okay. we're gonna do a cross and a side bend. I call this the willow tree. Other side. Let's do a side step. Toe raise. Take this driving out of these movements. Willow tree. This is to relax, to lengthen. Other side. So now we're gonna do a warrior two with our foot bladed there. Exalt, reach for the back knee. Warrior two, center. There you go. Other way. Warrior two, exalt, right. Warrior two, middle. Now you're just gonna throw it down. You have a strong core, but you're a noodle in your arms and your neck, your upper back. Woo. Side step and reach. There you go. Still in my heart somewhere. Full body, roll, other way. This is what the willow looked like last night in the storm. One more. Reach. I hear them call my name. Back to that whip. Up side. Warrior. Exalt. Warrior. Hold. Center. Other way. Throw it down. Whatever you're still holding on to. Maybe bend back a little bit. The kids used to call that the Bernie dance. Breathe in. And out. Stay down, push away, breathe in. Exhale, bring into your heart and up. Then, little Tai Chi movement. Out, stay down, push away. Exhale, bring it in. Another one. Away. Warrior. Exhale. Warrior two. Center. There you go. You got it. Other way. Warrior. Center. Take it out. I'm giving you permission to look a little silly. Want to stay down? Doesn't have to look a certain way, you guys. That's the way of the world, right? Deep breath in. Push away. Bring it in. Another one. Push away. Bring it to your mouth. All right. I'm going to grab a quick drink. Feel free to do so as well.
You were the word at the beginning.
All right.
One with God, the Lord Most High.
So this is a time to stretch out. Move around, whatever you need to do, whatever your body is asking for in this time. Or you can feel free to just follow along with me. Deep breath in.
What a beautiful name.
Let one hand sink down, the other presses up towards the sky. Bend it over. That's good.
What a beautiful name it is.
Back up. Other way.
What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus. You didn't want heaven without us. So Jesus,
let's go. Half this arm with one way. So this little sign I have behind me, go the other way, it says get your praise on, and I like to keep it wherever I'm working out. Grab your elbow and sway a little bit. God really does want your everyday. He wants you not just to say a prayer once a week or to go to church. I guess now tune in virtually on 5 years. He wants you to incorporate his love for you in all aspects of your life. And for me, let's slow right up. For me, it seems like I can just receive so much easier. Hands on your back pocket, kind of lean back. It's easier for me to receive after I've quieted my mind, and that happens after I've quieted my body too. So I just feel like this is a great opportunity. Come to all fours. Let him in. A little cat cow.
Get back into this child pose.
Lock it to one side. Other side. If you need to, you can kind of fold up your mat for your knee. Take a lunge here. Send the hips forward. Add an arm in. Nice hip opener here. Send the hips back. Open side.
So
now, I'd love for you to find a comfortable place, whether in child's pose again or just laying on your back, totally rested. I'm just gonna read our verse over you again. And I just want you to not try to overthink it or anything, just allow the words to wash over you and saturate into your now very open pores.
Okay.
For my people have committed a twofold sin. They have abandoned me, the fountain of fresh, flowing, living water. And they've dug for themselves cracked cisterns that can hold no water at all, that are no better than sieves. We all have a past, some good, some bad, some both. It's not really a matter of whether the past was cruel or kind to you. The greater danger lies in trying to live in what is gone. We were created to live not in the shadow of glory or shame, but in the light of now as we look to a future of increasing brightness. The attacks on your life have more to do with who you might be in the future than who you have been in the past. You look back and imagine that your actions have closed the only door you will ever have, or traumas or tragedies. Guess what? That's a lie. Yes, that door is closed, but if you turn around, you will find another one awaits you. It may look different. It may be even harder, but if you work with God, He will always get you where you need to be. He will always give you the tools you need to create a deep and reinforced well to draw from. Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for all of your children who have joined me here this morning and those who watch later. Lord, I just ask that you would bless them today. Turn their eyes and their hearts to you. You are the source of ever-flowing life, the living water. May we patch the holes through you so you can fill our souls, fill our hearts. In your name, amen. So you can go ahead and wiggle your toes and your fingers. Come to a seated position or standing position. Take a deep breath in and out. There you go.